Assalamu alaikum dear friends, this is Sajid Ali. Today I explain the topic coming of Europeans in India. So dear friends, in my last lectures we discussed about Muslims, how did they came and why. So dear friends, they came to India, Muslims came to India for the purpose of trade. And also Europeans came to India for the purpose of trade, but they both occupied Indian subcontinent and ruled so many years. First of all, Portuguese, they came 1498. Who was Vasco da Gama? Vasco da Gama was first Portuguese who was European, came to India, and who made route for other Europeans to trade with India, and they controlled different areas, especially Goa, from 1509 to 1961. They controlled especially Goa. French, they came to India and established French East India Company in 1667, and they control different areas to 1757, when British defeated the French East India Company. And Dutch, they came to India for the purpose of trade also, and established their trading post in Gujarat. They controlled these areas from 1605 to 1825. So dear friends, in this way these different communities, different tribes came to India from Europe, but they could not continue their rule, their trade. All in all, British when came to India, they defeated all other communities, Portuguese, French and Dutch. They came to subcontinent in 16, when Queen Elizabeth I, she was a queen of Great Britain, she permitted 15 traders to trade in India, and they established a company named British East India Company. So dear friends, when they started trading with Mughal Empire, at that time Jahangir was the ruler of India. He was a Muslim ruler. So when they came to India, at first they established their trading post in Surat. Surat is a region of Gujarat in 1608 in Bombay 1664, and in Kolkata 1690. So dear friends, when they established their factories in different areas, especially the coastal areas of Indian subcontinent, they they took silk, spices, cotton and opium from Indian people, from Indian state. In this way they trade with Indians. So it was at first profitable for both sides, for Europeans and Mughal state and Indian people. But after that, British East India Company started occupying different regions and it started interfering into the politics of Mughal Empire. So slowly and gradually it occupied all over the subcontinent and finished the vast and great Mughal Empire, established its own British Empire. Battle of Plassey was fought in 1757 between Nawab of Bengal Sirajuddaula and British East India Company. Its general was Lord Clive. When they fought this battle, the Battle of Plassey in 1757, Clive, the general of British East India Company who defeated Nawab of Bengal, it was fought in Bengal, so then killed him and appointed its own Nawab, Mir Jafar. Mir Jafar was bribed by British East India Company. Mir Jafar was the general of Sirajuddaula, but he deceived his Nawab, and then after the death of in the Battle of Plassey Sirajuddaula, he was appointed as a Nawab of Bengal. But he was is for the namesake Nawab. Behind him there was British East India Company. It started exploiting Bengal and after the Battle of Plassey it controlled and occupied all the regions of Bengal. So dear friends, after Mir Jafar, his son was seated. His name Mir Qasim. Mir Qasim was son of Mir Jafar, but he was not in favor of British East India Company. That's why he made Mughal Emperor his name Shah Alam II. Shah Alam II was Mughal Emperor at that time, and the Nizam of Hyderabad to fight British East India Company. These three leaders met together to fight British East India Company in the Battle of Buxar. It was fought in 1764. So dear friends, after the Battle of Buxar, British occupied some other areas like Odisha, Bihar and other areas which were near to Bengal. And then British East India Company became more stronger. And it started rule on different areas of subcontinent and appointed its Governor General, his name Warren Hastings, in 1780. 1873. But before the first Governor General, Clive was appointed as a Governor of Bengal when he won the Battle of Plassey from Sirajuddaula. So dear friends, Warren Hastings was the first Governor General of East India Company. When British occupied Bengal, Bihar, Odisha and other areas, it started occupying different largest areas and provinces and independent states. Just like Sindh was occupied by British in 1843 by under the leadership of Charles Napier. It was occupied by British East India Company into the British Empire, and Punjab was occupied in 1849. Mysore was a great independent state. Its ruler was Tipu Sultan, was occupied in 1799. By British East India Company. Marathas were also crushed in 1803. Then the regions of Marathas were also occupied. Doctrine of Leps. The Doctrine of Leps, it was a law and policy introduced by British East India Company to annex, to occupy, to possess different areas, different states. According to the Doctrine of Leps, if a ruler who had no son, real son, he cannot adopt other person. So, and after the death of that ruler, that states would be occupied by British East India Company. So it was in frame forced in 1848 by Lord Dalhousie. Dalhousie was Governor General of British East India Company, and as a result of Doctrine of Leps, some states were annexed, such as Satara, Sambalpur, Awadh, and other states, about 8 or 10 states. Different states were occupied. War of Independence. When such kind of annexation and such cruel policies of British was started, so public and people of India, including Mughal Emperor, became against the British East India Company and they fought a battle to get rid British East India Company from the subcontinent India, and as a result the War of Independence was fought between Indians and East India Company. It was fought in 1857. So dear friends, when the War of Independence was fought, Sikh community helped British East India Company. And Queen Victoria, when War of Independence was won, British East India Company, Queen Victoria proclaimed himself as a Queen of India in 1st November 1858. After 1858, United Kingdom directly ruled over India and British East India Company was ended. So in this way, the first Governor General of British was Lord Canning. So dear friends, in this way we discussed how Europeans coming to India and why they came to India. At first they came to India for the purpose of trade and business, but slowly and gradually they occupied it and ruled so many years, about one century. Thank you very much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.